Top 5 Fanboy Gripes. Number 3. This one thing about the ending of Harry Potter.
So of course I like Harry Potter because I'm a big disgusting nerd. I think it's a fantastic book series, and the movies are really good too. But like everything else, they're not quite perfect. But before I get into my gripe, I just want to kind of sit back and express my total admiration for something that J.K. Rowling was able to do with this series. She was one step ahead of her audience, and nobody ever guessed her ending. Now okay, let's just back up for a minute. When the first 3 books were published, basically only book readers knew about them. Most people didn't. It was right around 2001, when the first movie hit theaters and the 4th book was published, that Harry Potter fandom kind of exploded. For the next 5 years or so, Harry Potter fans would spend a significant portion of their miserable lives trying to decipher the secrets of the book and trying to figure out what happened next. And none of them got it right. Not a single one. Believe me, I was online at the time. Harry Potter nerds were writing these elaborate theories about how Mark Evans was going to be the Half-Blood Prince and the key to everything. Or the guy who ran the ice cream shop was some sort of secret mastermind behind it all. But with the release of every book, it was always completely different than anything that the fans theorized. The series twisted and turned and went places where you would have never imagined. It all felt natural, it wasn't gimmicky, but nobody guessed it. Ever. That's kind of amazing. See, for a while now, creators have kind of been complaining about the render farm of the internet. I think that's what J.J. Abrams called it. He said basically, if you're trying to write a mystery story, it's almost impossible to keep your twists a secret. Like with that show, Lost, if you have 100,000 dedicated fans who are all talking and trying to figure out what the twist is and what you're going to do next, at some point, they're going to figure it out. After the first season of Lost, pretty much everyone figured out that the plane crash survivors were actually in purgatory, so when the second season began, they had to change that around and pretend like, oh no, that's not the case. It's not purgatory, it's like science stations or something. Or hey, take a look at Game of Thrones. No matter how subtle George Martin tried to be with his big secret, everyone figured out that R plus L equals J, that Jon Snow was the son of Rhaegar Targaryen and Lyanna Stark. Hell, some random guy on the internet actually guessed that Hodor was in fact short for Hold the Door. You can't keep anything secret these days.
Varys is Rhaegar Targaryen. He's the real Rhaegar Targaryen, I'm telling you. They cut off his balls and then he shaved his head, but he is the true Targaryen. That's why he's helping Daenerys. You gotta believe me, I'm not crazy.
But I digress. The main thing is that J.K. Rowling was able to keep her final twists a complete secret, and she outsmarted everybody, all of the time. And she's gorgeous, and rich, and classy, and her Twitter feed is full of wit and humor, and... oh, God, Joe Rowling! But I digress. Anyway, as amazing as Harry Potter was, I think there was one thing that could have made it even better, and that's this. Harry and Voldemort should have been the same person. Now wait, hear me out on this. By now, we all know the final twist in Harry Potter, that when Voldemort was creating his Horcruxes with pieces of his soul, one of his little soul bits got attached to the baby Harry like a parasite. And so Harry Potter had this part of Voldemort's soul within him the whole time. But I don't think that was the plan all along. Especially, I'm thinking of Book 5, The Order of the Phoenix. If you recall, that's the one where Harry starts having wild mood swings, and he starts yelling and screaming at people. And his friends are all like, calm down, dude. Shut the fuck up. But wise old Dumbledore, he is genuinely freaked out by Harry's weird anger. And he drops these weird little hints where he'll examine a little magical device and he'll mutter cryptic clues like,
yes, but in essence, divided?
Throughout that whole book, Dumbledore was acting as if there was something very fundamentally shiesty about Harry Potter in general. That he wasn't just the cute kid that he'd been up till that point. So this is my theory. I think, at that point, in Book 5, the big reveal was going to be that Harry Potter actually did die as a baby, and that the soul inside his body was the soul of Voldemort, which by then had been split into like 7 different pieces. It makes sense, right? I mean, throughout the whole series, Voldemort's always pointing out how he and Harry Potter are so much alike. They can both talk to snakes. They kind of look alike. They're both these, you know, pale, brown-haired kids that come from shitty families. And then later in book 5, Harry Potter finally sees like this preserved memory of his father, James, and he and the audience are kind of surprised that Harry Potter's father isn't like him at all. He's kind of a normal jock type guy. And Harry Potter's like, wow, I can't believe this is my father. We have nothing in common. Ugh, I'm telling you, Harry Potter was supposed to be Voldemort. You know how throughout the whole series they refer to Harry Potter as the boy who lived? What if he didn't live? What if that was ironic? What if the real Harry Potter did die as a baby, but Voldemort's mutilated soul entered him and grew up thinking that he was Harry Potter? It would be his, you know, his spiritual redemption. The same soul, 2 different lives, one of them turned out wrong, the other one turned out good. So at the end, when the original Voldemort died, his little leftover soul of Tom Riddle was able to be redeemed and have this new life as Harry Potter. When Harry Potter takes that little trip to the afterlife to see Dumbledore, maybe he could have met the soul of the real Harry Potter there. Someone who looks just like him, but is just kind of a typical jock kid like his dad. Oh man, that could have just been the mind fuck for a whole generation. That would have been such a great twist, I think.
It's like, you know, I was having a dream of Jesus and Judas, but they were the same person, man.
Harry Potter was Voldemort. He was Tom Riddle. That's what I think she was planning, and I think she kind of chickened out and changed it at the last minute. Because at the end, when you find out that the little parasitic part of Voldemort's soul that can just be blasted off of Harry Potter and then he's fine, see, that's not very satisfying. It's just like an object that can be disposed of. It doesn't really have any deep spiritual meaning. But if Harry Potter and Voldemort were the same person, that would have made a great book series just even better. But again, I guess the reason this couldn't happen is because I guessed it. And as we've already established, no one was ever able to guess the ending. Still, I think it would have been better.
Also, Harry should have ended up with Luna. Luna's awesome. Jenny is a cheap ginger whore from a peasant family.
Okay, that's all I got for today. Tune in tomorrow when I examine how a masked villain is just kind of nerfed and ruined in the last act. No, not that one. We've already covered him. I'm talking about this guy right here. That's right. I have a gripe with my favorite cartoon series of all time. Seriously, why can't things just be perfect?
Well done, Draco. Well done.